Very good morning to one and all. I am your Rajesh sir, here with the topic pronouns. In previous classes, we learned kinds of pronouns. In this class, I am going to revise in brief. Here, see, the topic name is pronoun. As we learned in the previous classes, pronoun is a part of parts of speech. Here we have 8 parts of speech, and the pronoun is one of the part of that speech. Here pronoun means for a noun. Pronoun means for a noun. And generally we use this pronoun in place of our instead of or substitute of noun, or we replace the noun with pronoun. As we learned that the pronouns are of many kinds of pronouns. In general, there are 9 kinds of pronouns. Here see, the first one is personal pronoun. Personal pronoun. Here after this, observing this personal pronoun, they divided into 2 ways. One is subjective, and the second one is objective. Then after personal, here we have another kind called possessive pronoun. Possessive pronoun. This explains the ownership. Then here the reflexive pronoun. Reflexive pronoun and emphatic pronoun. Emphatic pronoun. Reflexive and emphatic both have the same forms, but they have some different usages. Here the reflexives are after adding the object self or selves, it's formed. Then demonstrative pronoun. Demonstrative pronoun. It demonstrates or shows this, that, these, those. Here, distributive pronouns. Here, we use this for distributive. Here, we learned in the previous classes how the distributive verbs pronouns are used. Then, indefinite pronouns. It not shows the particular person, but it's used in general way. And here, reciprocal pronoun. Here we are using this reciprocal pronouns. We have only 2 reciprocal pronouns, as we learned in the previous class. Each other and one another. And here, relative pronouns, as we learned in the previous classes, the relative pronouns we used to add the 2 sentences or 2 clauses. Here the relative pronouns, what is also one of the relative pronouns, but we generally use who, whom, whose, which, that. And here, interrogative pronouns. Interrogative pronouns, the same words which we use in the relative pronouns, we also use it as interrogative pronouns, but it forms the question and end with question mark. Here see, personal pronouns 1, possessive pronouns 2, reflexive and emphatic pronouns 3, demonstrative pronouns 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9. Personal pronouns, possessive pronouns, reflexive pronouns and emphatic pronouns, demonstrative pronouns, distributive pronouns, indefinite pronouns, reciprocal pronouns, relative pronouns and interrogative pronouns. In previous classes we have learned in detail. In this class I will explain you superficially, brief. Pronouns, as we discussed just, pronouns used in place of nouns or instead of nouns or substitute of nouns. We replace noun and we write pronoun. Here it avoids the repetition. Here see, we have different kinds of pronouns and here a brief explanation on this topic. If you need a detailed one, you please go to the individual videos which I uploaded in the YouTube. Here, personal pronouns. We use pronouns in place of nouns. Generally, we use pronouns in the place of subject as I, we, you, they, he, she, it. And in this, we have singular and plural and also feminine, masculine and neuter gender. Here see, this he we use for masculine gender and this she for the feminine gender, and it's an impersonal pronoun and we use for things or non-living things. And here in the subjective case we use I, we, you, they, he, she, it, and the objective case we use in place of I, me, us, you, them, him, her, it. Here this it is same in the subjective and objective. Here see the example, then you can understand easily. I saw him, it's possible. I saw her, I saw them, I saw it, I saw you. Okay, if you want to replace this I with another also, it possible. Here she saw us and me. Here in this us, you are also included. And here me means you. I saw he, she saw me. Means she is a feminine gender when we don't know. Who is she? When it's not mentioned the name. Here, me. It's you. And the next one is possessive pronouns. These possessive pronouns we use to indicate ownership, relationship or possession. Here see these examples. This pen is mine. This pen is mine, or this piece of chalk is mine. I have the ownership on this chalk piece, a piece of chalk. Here see, in the possessive pronouns we use mine, your, yours, his, her. Here these are the possessions of I, we, you, they, he, she, it. Here for I we use mine. Here we use our or ours, and them there are theirs. For he his, for her hers, and its. See the example. This pen is mine, your, yours, his or her. These pens are our or ours. They are this. This cap is its. In this way we use possessive pronouns. Here don't confuse In the personal pronouns, we have subjective and objective, and in the possessive, we use the ownership belongs to. The next one is reflexive and emphatic pronouns. Reflexive and emphatic pronouns have the both have the same forms. Both have same forms, and these forms are formed by adding self or self. We are adding the self or self to the objective pronoun for indicating yourself. Some words are there which done by themselves, herself, themselves, herself, himself, or myself. For that kind of words, that kinds of expressions, we use this reflexive. And when we are saying or assuring, or we are saying 100%ly it done by you, or done by somebody else, and you saw with your naked eyes, we use this emphatic pronouns. I saw, or I myself saw you. In this way we are using. You see the examples. I saw myself. Here I saw myself. After the verb we use, after the verb we use myself, if we use after the verb, we call it as reflexive pronoun. Here it reflects the same person who is seeing in the mirror. And here in the second sentence, we are writing immediately after the pronoun. Immediately after the pronoun. This is called emphatic pronoun. Here is emphasizing or pressuring that 100%. I myself saw in the mirror. And here, myself, ourselves, here we are using ourselves. Here yourself, when we are indicating for more or one, we are using you only. For the singular and the plural, we use you only. When we are indicating as a singular, use you, yourself, or you, yourselves. And he, himself, she, herself, they, themselves, it, itself. In this way, we use this reflexive and emphatic pronouns. And the next one is demonstrative pronouns. Okay, this is a piece of chalk. That is a sky. This is a building. That is a building. Those are pens. These are pens. For showing, we use this demonstrative pronouns. Are pointing out people or things, we use this demonstrative pronouns. For showing or pointing, we use demonstrative pronouns. They are this, that, these, those. And here, singular one is this, that. When we are speaking about one person or one thing, we use this or that. When we are speaking more than one, and when it is near, we use these. When it is far from you, we use those. These, those. Here, this and these. For near people and things, we use that and those. For people and things, we use. You see the example so that you can understand well. This is a pen. These are pens. That is a pen. Those are pens. Here, so the plural. Here the plural. So we are using according to the plural. We are using the verb. These are the singulars. According to the singular, we are using the verb. This is about demonstrative pronouns. Just we learnt few kinds of pronouns and the other indefinite pronouns. Indefinite pronouns, distributive pronouns, and reciprocal pronouns are somehow confused because they are not mentioning the specific one. In general, we are using these all. Here, see, observe these indefinite pronouns. Does not refer any specific person or thing. Here, example are any, anyone, each, everybody, everything, few, many, both, one, some, someone, no one. Here we are not mentioning any particular person or thing, but in general we are using. If you see the examples, all is well. Here we don't know what is this all. Everything is well. We don't know what is that all. Each has its own thoughts. Here this each, it is not used in a general way, not used in a specific way, it's used in general way. Each has, we don't know who has that. Each means indicating all. Can anyone answer this question? It is a general asked question. Here we are asking to answer anyone. Can anyone? Anyone means maybe you, maybe they, maybe he, maybe she. Anyone can answer this question. In this way we are using indefinite pronouns, and these are the words we are using. And here another more list is there in individual video we given this. If you have any doubts regarding these topics, once you go and revise this topic. And here distributive pronouns. Here as I told in the previous video, the distribute means giving or distributing. Here we have only few pronouns which explaining this distribution. Here each, either, neither, none. These are the words we are using as distributive pronouns. It is explaining, refer members of the groups separately. Here the group of members are there, but individually it speaks, but not mentioning the particular thing. Here each new day is different. We have a list of days. In a year we have 365 days. Here, but here, each day from these, it's speaking about one individual days. Each new day is different. Neither answer is correct. Here the many answers is yes. Here neither one or two. Both the answers is correct. Neither and either we generally use for indicating two. Each for indicating many. None of our friends went to the party. Here none means from many. You have a number of friends, but none means no one of our friends went to the party. Either, maybe he, maybe she, or maybe he, or maybe she. Either of you come with me. Maybe this boy, that boy, she or her, come with me. We are not specifically mentioning. In this way we are using distributive pronouns. And this each we also use in the indefinite pronoun. They are reciprocal pronouns. Reciprocal. It is indicating two or more persons. Two or more persons. Here we have only two reciprocal pronouns, one each other, and the second one is one another. Each other, we are using this word for two, and when it is more than two, we use one another. Here I told you that, and you remember for this, we use in three, more than two. 3, 4, 10, whatever it may be. Here, one another, more than three, we use this. Here, some words we generally use here. Two brothers like each other. Here, in place of two, here write down, we, here two friends or three friends, we like each other. Each other. Here this we, according to the writer or according to the speaker, we can understand we may be indicated two or more than two. It is on the point of view of the speaker or the writer. If this we mentioning more than two, then the possibility to write one another. So don't confuse with these. Maybe each other is also possible and one another is also possible. And the same thing happens with they. They like each other or they like one another. Here the they, we can also possible to use for two or more than two. Here one another is also possible and each other is also possible. This is somehow confusing, but if you learn it perfectly, you can easily use in your sentences. Here see the examples. Two brothers like each other. Here we are mentioning two, so that we are writing each other. Three friends like one another. We are mentioning the three, so we are using one another. Here the relative pronouns. Here relative pronouns we learned in the previous classes. I have given the two videos on this. One with difference between how to use who and whom, and another one is whose, which and that. How to use them in your sentences. Here we used to mention the previous noun, the person which you are spoke or which you speak, used to join two sentences, and I also giving the number of examples to understand this concept. Here the few examples to understand. The man and the same man I am referring. So I am speaking about the same noun which I mentioned. So I have written who. He is wearing a cap, is my friend. This is a boy whom all like, and with this whom we use in the objective case, and this who in the subjective case. Subjective case and whom in the objective case. I don't know whose pen is this. This possession for ownership we are using this whose. All that, here that, when we are using all, any, some, such, this type of words, we are using that. I mentioned in the previous video, all that I speak refer to the topic. And here we have the which is also used for non-living things. And here, these are all about pronouns. And here the one is there. Interrogative pronoun, I will discuss about. Interrogative pronoun. It is the last kind of pronouns, but not the least pronoun. It's a very, very important one. Here we are using these interrogative pronouns for asking questions and end with question mark. And we are using interrogative question words for asking these questions. Interrogative pronouns. And the list of interrogative pronouns are question words: what, which, who, whom, whose. And here we are adding the suffix and we are forming the compound interrogative pronouns: whatever, whatsoever, whichever, whosoever, whomsoever, whose. In this way we are forming compound interrogative pronouns. And here see the examples. What is that? Which is yours? Who done it? Whom shall we ask? Whose is this pen? Here one thing you remind in your mind, that after these interrogative pronouns we are using verbs. We are using verbs. If we are using this verbs, so only we call this type of these question words as interrogative pronouns. If we use after these question words noun, we call it as adjective. We learn the difference while I was teaching interrogative pronouns. But here you must remember, after what or question words, we are using verbs for making interrogative pronouns questions. Remember, these are all kinds of pronouns and use them in your daily life. And while you are reading any text or newspaper, While you encounter this type of pronouns, you must underline them and learn the way it used. And while writing the essays or any descriptions, use these pronouns and use or write effectively. Thank you. Thanks for watching.